Today, we're diving deep inside the logs of a massive internet outage. We're going to uncover a secret, a split-second decision that, honestly, might have saved the web from a total meltdown.
Why did Cloudflare deliberately pull the plug on London today? The logs reveal a dramatic decision.
All right, so let's set the scene. It's November 18th, 2025. At 11:48 UTC, a critical alert flares up. Cloudflare, you know, the company that basically acts as the foundation for a huge piece of the internet, is starting to crumble. And get this, it's not some external attack. Their own systems are failing, and on a global scale.
So what did this actually feel like for you and me? Well, the impact was immediate, and it was chaotic. All these major services that have nothing to do with each other just stopped working. X, ChatGPT, Spotify, even huge games like League of Legends, all of them started throwing up those dreaded 500 internal server errors. It's like the internet was having a full-blown panic attack. The chaos was so bad that even Down Detector, the website everyone rushes to when things break, went down too.
So behind the scenes, the network was just bleeding out. Engineers were basically flying blind, scrambling to fix a system that holds up so much of our digital lives. But their own tools were failing them. They were staring at a terrifying choice: make a drastic move right now or risk watching the whole thing collapse.
So what could they possibly do? Well, their decision came down to one specific service, Cloudflare Warp. To put it simply, Warp is a tool that makes your internet connection more secure and often faster. It's a huge deal for them. Millions of people use it. And in this moment of crisis, it was about to become the sacrificial lamb.
And here it is, the smoking gun, buried in a public status log, an entry from 1304 UTC. It's chillingly simple. During our attempts to remediate, we have disabled Warp access in London. Just like that. They intentionally cut off a major service to one of the world's biggest cities. It was a calculated, absolutely brutal sacrifice to relieve the pressure and save the entire network.
So did this insane gamble actually pay off? Oh yeah, and it paid off fast. Just look at this timeline. At 1304, they pull the plug on London. That gives them just enough breathing room so that 5 minutes later, at 1309, they find the core problem and push a fix. And then, just 4 minutes after that, at 1313, London is back. The whole crisis, from sacrifice to fix to recovery, was over in 9 minutes. Nine! That's less time than it takes to make a cup of coffee. It's just incredible.
This is just a powerful, raw lesson in high-stakes engineering. To stop a total meltdown that could have crippled the web for hours, they made a tough surgical decision. It really proves the old saying, doesn't it? Sometimes you have to cut off a limb to save the body.
And you know, this whole thing leaves you with a much bigger question. As more and more of the internet relies on just a handful of these giant companies, you have to wonder, what other invisible sacrifices are being made? What other Londons are being quietly cut off, just for a moment, to keep the lights on for the rest of us? It's definitely something to think about.